That's some hideous viral footage of a hair-like parasite emerging from the body of a praying mantis.
What's happening here? Let's get some deets.
Just watching this long, black, tentacle-like creature emerge from its far shorter host calls to mind the horrors of The Strain, Slither, and of course, Alien.
But of course, as monstrous as it seems, we're actually observing a real-world organism with a real-world parasitic agenda.
What we see here is a parasitoid worm from the phylum Nematomorpha. They're also known as horsehair worms because these thread-like roundworms do resemble the hair of a horse's tail or mane.
And it squirms around and takes up residence inside a cricket, mantis, beetle, or other host organism.
You may have observed these creatures before, either emerging from a squashed host or living free in a puddle or stream.
See, the adults are free living, but the larvae are parasitic and grow to adulthood in the body of an insect. And here's how it goes down.
Horsehair worms make their home in damp soil and fresh water. It's here that the male and females mate, and it's here that the female lays millions of eggs. These eggs hatch, and the tiny larvae insist on vegetation near the water's edge.
Then what happens? Why, a cricket or some other suitable host drops by and eats that insisted larvae, or in the case of the carnivorous mantis, it acquires the parasite by devouring an already infected intermediate host, such as a mosquito larva.
Once inside its final host, the cyst covering dissolves inside the insect's gut, allowing the juvenile worm to escape, bore through the gut wall, and then start absorbing the host's nutrients.
And then our horsehair worm grows and grows till it's time to burst free. Oh sure, it'll abandon ship if the host dies, but what it needs is fresh water or damp soil.
And so here we see a bit of parasitic hijacking in action. That's one hypothesis anyway, that the worm instills a crazed thirst in the host so that it seeks out water. An alternate hypothesis states that the worm simply waits till the host finds water on its own and then bursts forth.
According to a 2001 paper from German journal Zoologische Anzeiger, the thirst hypothesis is supported by observations of suicidal behavior by infected mantises in southern France who seemingly jump into the river and give birth to the worm that consumed them.
But hey, at least this ends the mantis's suffering. Usually there's just one ghastly black worm inside of it, eating it from the inside out. Sometimes, however, it's twins. So what about you? Have you ever seen a horsehair worm in action? The first time I saw one, it was in a junior high band room, and it was wriggling out of the body of a dead cricket.
True story. What about you? Let us know in the comments below, and to keep the videos coming, make sure to subscribe.